Welcome, everyone, to the Thrillcast. With us is Chad Gracey from the Multi-Platinum Rock Band Live. If you have any questions, start asking him. And then, if he's feeling it, he's going to start playing some songs.
Maybe.
Chad, Mel Wilson has a question. He's saying, favorite bands in different genres, metal, hard rock, punk, grunge, pop.
Jesus.
Thanks.
Wow.
Yeah.
By genre?
By genre.
Wow. I don't go by genre.
Yeah.
I went to high school with Mel. What's up, Mel?
Oh, okay.
Favorite bands? U2, Queens of the Stone Age, Them Crooked Vultures, Royal Blood. Lots of 80s bands, Cure, Smiths, R.E.M. I'll probably leave important shit out. Soundgarden, STP, Pearl Jam, Smashing Pumpkins. You know, a lot of my contemporaries are our contemporaries. The bands, yeah. The contemporaries, I like a lot of those bands. Absolutely.
Someone's saying, if you weren't a drummer, what would you do?
I answered this question last time. Yeah. May have been a doctor. I liked medicine.
Got new listeners now, buddy.
Hey.
Yeah.
Hi, new people.
That was Noreen Fong that asked that
Noreen.
Question.
Noreen.
She probably already knows that answer.
She's, yeah. How's Better Call Saul, Noreen?
Yeah.
I'm going to watch it soon.
What's your Tool? Do you like Tool? Jonathan
I do like
Tool.
Yes, yeah. Yes. I'll leave a lot out. Yeah, Tool. Danny Carey is... in my opinion, the best drummer living right now, so.
Wow.
My opinion, whatever.
Yeah. Is he really?
Oh. Yeah.
Better than you?
Better than me.
Wow.
And then Dave Grohl's a very close second, nice. In my opinion. In my opinion. Then Matt Cameron. I mean, I can go down the line, but whatever.
Yeah. Get your questions in, people, you know. Joe Rizzullo says his two favorite drummers growing up in the 70s and 80s, where were you? Were teething, Joe? Were Neil Peart and Stuart Copeland. Who were yours?
Stuart Copeland, The Police, yes. He's amazing as well. Neil Peart, legendary. It's sad that he's gone. I mean, my earliest influence was probably Ringo Starr because that's the first record, a Beatles record, and I can't remember exactly
Beatles.
Which one.
Yeah,
but I put that on and learned how to play the basics, figured out what was what. I mean, of course, you have to love John Bonham. Mm-hmm. I mean, probably the best rock drummer to ever live.
Is that true?
I think so.
Nice.
I mean, there's, you know, everyone has their own opinions, but
I thought his son was pretty good in that
Jason
Kennedy Honors.
Absolutely, Jason. There, you can't take anything away from him. But. The feel that his dad had, and, you know, John was just, you know, unprecedented. So, anyway, what else? Yeah.
This guy's saying, Chad, can you take us through All Over You slowly? I could never quite figure it out.
Slowly.
I don't think he was going to do that, right? But we do have some cool overhead shots.
I'm going to do All Over You at some point soon. But
not today.
Not today. Sorry.
Yeah. And you could slow it down.
Yeah. That's the thing. It's hard to slow down and, like, show.
Robert Hager, hey, Rob, is saying, should we ask Dallas's son who is the best drummer is?
Always.
Is that that's an inside question?
Yeah, my buddy Dallas's son, Dallas, Little Dallas.
Little D. Was
little D.
Big D.
He, the first time I met him, he said, the best drummer is the drummer from Foreigner.
Foreigner. Oh, okay.
I mean, that guy's great.
I guess. Do you write your own music apart from the band?
No.
No.
No. What's the last thing the drummer said to the band? Let's try one of my songs.
Yeah.
Ha, ha, ha.
Yeah. So how does that work, though? So when, you know, Ed or Patrick or, you know, get a part and they have the music, basically it's pretty much done and then you hear it and then you start playing your part to it?
All kinds of ways. It could start with we're sitting in the room playing to a bass idea or a guitar idea, all the way to Ed bringing in a full song with verse, chorus, bridges, all arranged and playing to that. So it's a variety of ways.
Okay. And then, what's the song that got you wanting to play drums or even be in a band?
Hmm. Lots of them. I mean, I was always tapping on the back seat of my mom's or my dad's, you know, front seat in the car. And, geez.
You still do that.
Just a lot. I still do that, yeah. I mean, really, the drummer that inspired me the most is Larry Mullins Jr. from U2. I mean, that's... Once I graduated from Beatles, I really started... That's when Joshua Tree was out and U2 was huge. I was listening to War before that and Unforgettable Fire. And then Joshua Tree and, you know, I mean, I have my floor tom on the left because of Larry, so I copied him.
Oh, okay. No, I'm not asking that, Noreen. Noreen's asking some. She wants to know this. If you want a cage match thing, that's like, you know.
Noreen.
I don't even. This. Some of the questions are. Ever thought of a drum song called Number? Question mark. What the fuck? Is
I don't.
That's probably an inside joke.
I don't know what that is.
Do you have a preferred drumstick length, thickness? Does it make a difference?
I play this length, and it's kind of a 5AB Pro Mark.
How do you share this?
I don't know what I mean. It's 5AB. I don't know what the exact length is. I'd have to measure it, but and I have the Pro Grip stuff on it, so it's grippy. This has saved my life. I love this stuff.
And then
and they're cool black.
Do you prefer inside or outside venues?
Oh my. Depends on what the temperature is outside. If it's really hot, inside. The hottest show we ever played that I remember was in Austin, Texas in 1995, outside. It was 100 degrees at night and about 95% humidity.
So Joshua Talley says, Irish drum parts are amazing. How did that come to you?
I don't know how it came to me. I forget who brought that idea to. I think it was maybe Chad. He brought the idea in the da na na na.
Yeah.
And we just started playing to it, and just that it just that drum part just evolved out of playing the song many, many times.
Why don't you show the fans what that looks like real time? How about that, Dan?
We can do that.
Chad, you want to get that going?
Let's get that going. We can play Iris. I'll play most of the song.
Here you go, guys. And Chad Gracey playing Iris. Yesterday, sunset. What did everyone think of that? That was Chad Gracey from the multi-platinum rock band Live. And he knows how to play some drums. So, Mark Curran,
I hope
he's on me. He wants me to ask his question. He thought we forgot him, but you have so many questions coming in. Josh Talley says, fucking killer. We're allowed to curse here. So
fuck yeah. Thank you, Josh.
I know Chris Alenka was in. Hi, Chris. And
what's up, Z-Man?
Mark Curran wants to know if you're... he's like, am I an invisible man over here? Yeah, I can't see you.
Damn, Mark.
He wants to know if you are rehearsing with Zach yet for any tour dates.
We have not rehearsed with Zach yet.
Yeah.
But we will be.
Yeah, of course. And then Tony Ann Rizzullo wants to know, why don't you wear shoes when you drum?
Because I set my drum set up in my room when I first got it. And I never put shoes on, and that's how I learned to play. So I never had shoes on. I've been in bare feet in the shittiest clubs, CBGBs for one. I've been in bare feet in 32 degree weather.
I wouldn't do it.
It's I can't play with shoes on now. So it's like a kind of a height thing.
Damian Escobar just chimed in.
What's up, Damian?
Damian Escobar, also a multi-platinum artist. And he's coming to the studio very soon as well. And he says, you're a legend.
Ah, thank you, sir.
So how many calories do you burn?
That's a good question.
I
need to wear do they call those things? Heart rate monitor. I don't know. A lot.
Tony Ann says she loves that you're barefoot. She must have a foot fetish. Something like that. Anyway.
Uh-oh.
He gets manicures. And Joshua Menard, is your shoulder completely healed? But I don't think it was your shoulder.
I didn't injure my shoulder. It was my elbow.
Yeah.
Actually, tricep tendon, 90% tear. And yes, it is 100% healed now. Yeah. Yep. No All surgery. Right. I'll tell you later how I did it.
Yeah, we did that on the last one. So... we are on our way to Music Fest in Bethlehem, PA. Please come back.
Hey, Music Fest is great. I'm sure we'll play there again.
How much rest do you want to play in between? What do you want to play next, Chad Gracey?
I don't know. I've been wanting to play White Discussion.
Why don't you do that?
Okay.
Do you want to do it now?
We can, yeah.
I mean, you know, when Ed's singing in front of you, he doesn't give you much time to rest.
Well, I mean, listen.
Lightning. You want to start Lightning Crashes? You'll be off for 2.5 minutes.
Yeah, I'll just sit here for 2 minutes.
That's funny. All right. Let's hear a little. Dan, you ready? Some White Discussion from the multi-platinum rock band Live.
Thank you.
Woo!
Am I back on or no?
Woo, yeah, Chad Gracey. Somebody says we're washing dishes at Grand Falloons to this.
Yes!
Angela Strode Winter. We know Angela. Oh, she's awesome.
She knows that because that's what I used to do.
Yeah. Remember when you guys got back together in like 2016, Ed, and you guys went to Grand Falloons?
Yeah.
I know MG was there. Ed walked into the kitchen. And he was like, yeah, and the salad station was here. It was kind of funny. Hey, is Live going on tour, Chad Gracey?
At some point, yes.
Stage. Oh, he's not. I don't think he's going to play stage today. Yeah,
not today.
Yeah.
Not today. I'm getting back in drum shape. It's going to be a while.
Yeah, somebody said, hello, fellow Pennsylvanian.
Yes. PA in the house.
All right. Let's see. You make my soul feel great. So Joshua Talley said that.
Ah. Well, I appreciate that. Thank
you. Noreen saying she's sweating watching.
Cool.
Melanie, welcome. I think she Aussie, right? So awesome to be able to hear the drums over everything else for a change. Rich Maxwell says, thanks, Chad. Tammy.
Yeah, Rich wanted to see that one.
Oh, really?
Yes.
That was special request from Rich. Good job, Rich. That was awesome, man. And I'm 4 miles from Think Loud. I think I can see you. We don't call it Think Loud anymore.
But that's cool.
We can think noise, right?
There you go.
Mary Swain said she might need to smoke a cigarette after that, and she doesn't even smoke cigarettes. So I think she's saying you just gave her an orgasm.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Rob Hager saying this is getting real now. Hey, man, we tried to take the high road and be nice, but, you know.
Exactly.
And I got a platform where on my YouTube channel, 35,000 people at a time can come and hear it. So we will do it anyway. Live at the Paradiso. Oh, Troy Ruth. Live at the Paradiso videos. You have some tech off to your left monitor. Been a while since I watched this. You recall what you were using there to support you?
No.
And if anything interesting, do you still use similar tech during shows? I think you just have a laptop, right?
We run a laptop now.
With the track?
Yeah, some tracks, yeah. Not every song, but some tracks, yeah. So, but yeah, it was, I forget what it was then, at Paradiso. That was 2008.
Straya, that's right. Hey, hi from the UK. All right. And then tell him T-Bone said hey.
T-Bone.
Terry Rowe.
Oh, Terry. What's up, Terry?
Yeah.
How you doing, buddy?
And let's see. What else? From Ohio. Did you start out playing match grip? What the hell does that mean?
I've always played Match Grip. The way I play. Yeah, I've never played Classic.
Oh, okay.
Always Match.
Yeah, I'm just like, what the hell?
I know a few technical terms in drumming.
Yeah, I don't know any of that stuff. If you weren't here, I'd be like, well, then we wouldn't have a show right now with you on drums.
That's true.
Any other questions? What other songs did you want to play for these fine folks today?
Well, I had those two worked out. I mean, I don't think we have anything else pulled up.
Okay. That's fine. We weren't going to keep this too long anyway. It was always planned on just a half hour.
I'm making several drum videos with this whole setup, so the next batch will be with all these, you know, different camera angles and along with the track. So we're getting more professional as we go here.
Terry Rowe wants Lakinis, but I think that's going to be recorded later and then you upload it to all your social medias.
Yes. Yes, but thank you, Terry. I'm already tired.
Yeah. Rachel Herndon said, thanks for being one of her inspirations at 11 years of age, 31
oh, cool.
years later.
Oh, well. You are welcome. I appreciate the praise. I love that.
John Dickey. Hey, Chad, longtime fan. I appreciate you commenting on my drum cover of Selling the Drama. Meant a lot to me. Can you jam Waterboy for us? So maybe at a later date. I don't think he has.
I'll make Waterboy. I'm gonna do Selling the Drama in this next batch, too. But I'll do Waterboy at some point because going back to those Mental Jewelry beats are like, that's really cool stuff. So,
do you have a favorite Gracious Few track to play?
Appetite.
Yeah, that's a good song.
That was the teaser I put up the other day, was Appetite.
Oh, somebody actually asked that. They said, what was the song that you played the other day? And I didn't even know that one.
That's a song called Appetite on the Gracious Few record.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I was like, is it U2 or something? I thought it was like one of the other bands.
And the Gracious Few was, you know, the three of us with Kevin Martin and Sean Hennessy, Memphis.
Yep. A lot of Christy Epp said they're tired just from watching. You're tired, yeah. SJ Clips, I don't know who that is, says, would you ever consider giving private drum lessons virtually? You don't want drum lessons from him.
I'm not a very patient teacher, so.
Yeah, exactly.
I was not born to teach, so sorry, no.
Scott Young says he's caught three of your drumsticks at separate gigs in Glasgow over the years.
Oh, shit, nice. Yeah, we haven't been to Glasgow in a while.
Kevin, my name is Bill Hines. I'm the host of the Thrillcast, and that's who's talking besides Chad. Sorry, I'm off camera because this is all about Chad and him playing those couple songs. And obviously, this went over pretty well. We'll do it again.
Yeah.
And
do it again, do some more stuff.
Yeah, and it'll stay live up and, you know, you could rewatch Chad doing the drum parts and all of that stuff, you know.
Yeah.
And then Laura Couchless says, smartest decision she's ever made was traveling to Holland to see you guys.
It's a good place to see us. We have a lot of rabid Netherlands fans. It's awesome to go there.
Holland is one of your favorite cities, right?
Yes, I have a daughter named Holland.
Yep. And
it's a country, but not.
Oh,
Amsterdam.
Yeah, sorry, that's what I meant. Amsterdam. Whatever. I'm trying to read these comments and do it. It is. Yeah. Such a Gracey. How late? How? What? He's saying, how long have you been playing drums for the band live? Well,
since inception.
Yeah, Chad's the original drummer, the only drummer. Yeah. And then they, let's say, which TGF tune had the Gracious beat?
The Gracious beat?
What does that even mean?
I don't know.
Was that the live song that converted to that or no?
No, I'm not sure. I'm not sure about that question.
All right. Well, I think, obviously we got way too many questions. This was only supposed to be about a 30-minute quick episode, him playing a couple songs. So, I don't know, Chad. You got anything else?
I don't. We'll do more of these. And I'm making more videos, and they'll be on my Instagram, at the Chad Gracey. And you can see them there.
And Rachel wants to know, why do you never age? She said, you looking fine.
Thank you. I take, and this is no joke, I take a lot of vitamins. A lot. All kinds of supplements and shit. I take handfuls of pills at morning and evening.
Oh, Elizabeth Shorten Heingartner says, hello, Chad.
Hey, what's up?
She's always been awesome.
It's Aunt Beth.
Aunt Beth, yeah, that's right. Hello, Aunt Beth from the wonderful world of York, Pennsylvania.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she's awesome. So, anyway, is Adam coming back?
I don't know.
It's probably an Ed decision, right?
I think so, yeah. I have no idea.
But for they said, as of now, who's in the band live?
As of now?
That's what they're...
Patrick, Chad, Gracey, and Ed.
Okay. Cool. But Zach, they meant like who's going to tour.
Well.
You don't know that yet?
I mean, I think Zach's touring.
Yeah.
But I can neither confirm nor completely deny it. So
I like Zach. He's a nice guy.
Zach's awesome.
Yeah. Alrighty. Other than that, I think we're going to be good, right? Thank you, everyone, for listening.
Thanks, everyone. Take care. We'll be back soon.